Dire team back. Radiant team back. Seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Dire team back. Radiant team back. Remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Dire team pick.
Abyssal Underlord.
Radiant team pick. Remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Radiant team pick. Reserve time.
Disruptor.
Dire team pick.
Juggernaut.
Radiant team back. Remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time.
Ah, come on.
Dire team ban. Radiant team ban. Seconds remaining. Dire team back.
Yo, what's up, my guys? It's time for some Dota 2. That's fun and stuff. So, sometimes I can't really hear as much as I want to, but I'm sure that's going to be completely fine as we get into this match between Duop and Team Freedom. This is the upper bracket final. The winner will be moving on to the grand final. to be played in a couple of days here. So we'll be getting through this match. This is actually a rematch of the PD Cup Grand Final that was a couple of months ago that Duop ended up coming out on top of over Freedom. But that was before everything changed. That was before the new patch. So definitely a lot is different since then. And Team Freedom have been on an absolute tear ever since that patch came out. Not too many people have been able to beat them. We'll see if Duop are going to be able to be one of the few today. Team Freedom don't always try all that much, but I'm sure they're going to be putting a lot of effort into this game, because this is definitely going to mean a lot when it comes to that grand final. Not really sure why Team Freedom and Duop, they will not be receiving the one game upper bracket advantage in the grand final. Apparently they are supposed to, whoever wins this one will go on to the grand final and will not get an advantage at all. So it'll just be a straight best of five for whatever team gets there. So winning this match doesn't really do as much, except for the fact that they are not going to have to go through the lower bracket at all in order to get back to the grand final. So the shortest path to victory here for teams is really the goal. This is only the third match in the upper bracket. Meanwhile, teams have been duking it out all over the place in the lower. So definitely a good thing to get into that grand final very quickly, not revealing so many of the strats. But things have been pretty usual here for the teams as we look through the draft. So now Duop, they managed to get the Underlord for Snake King, something that's been quite a dominant offlaner. And they'll also get a Juggernaut there as well. Shadow Demon was banned out by Team Freedom, so we're not going to see any kind of combo with that. But there's still a lot that Duop could go with here. Team Freedom picking up the Abaddon for IX Mike, also the Disruptor and the Spirit Breaker for Juby. That's going to be a pretty excellent support duo.
10 seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining.
So, Team Freedom, they are going blue again. We've seen a lot of teams trying to go with the blue lineup, and some of them are doing well with it. I actually don't even know the stats on it. I'm just kind of throwing out some BS there, but you know, we get the opposite of BS here with the Spirit Breaker. See how I turn that around? You got to turn everything around here. So Team Freedom, they've got their support duo, and we'll see what Duop can do against it. Generally, when we see the Spirit Breaker, you start to think early aggression all over the map, since he does have that global charge and can do quite a bit with it. But IX Mike's Abaddon isn't really going to be so aggressive in the lane, especially if he's going to be soloing against the Pit Ward. We'll see how those lanes worked out. Really, it's going to be Juby making some space on the mid lane. Also see the Rubick picked up here for Duop, which could be good against the Spirit Breaker. As long as he doesn't get stunned out, he can always lift the Spirit Breaker out of the, oh my lord, out of the charge. But seriously, Team Freedom picking up a Klynx here. Brooklyn Kurt's going to be making an appearance, and this is probably something that they've practiced quite a bit with. I would assume that's going to be BSJ on the Klynx. And we've seen how Minus Armor has been playing a pretty big role in a lot of these games. And Duop decided to pick an Ember Spear into that as well. So while the Desolator is an excellent item for Klynx to get, might also be called on to go for a Bloodthorn this game as well. Orc and Malevolence into that one. We'll be doing quite a bit of damage and might be very good against the Ember, which would force the Ember to go for the Lincoln Sphere a little bit earlier.
Reserve time.
So we are down to our last bans for each team. With Duop getting the Ember Spirit, they get a little bit more control here. And they actually have quite a bit of lockdown on their team. So they have Ember Spirit Chains, Rubick Lift, and Underworld Pit of Malice. That's quite a bit of control that they can have around the fights, and they might be able to work around that pretty well with Juggernaut doing some nice damage inside of it. But Team Freedom kind of have a lineup that don't necessarily have to go through a lot of these disables. Maybe the Spirit Break can get hit by the Searing Chains, but he'd have to get pretty close to Ember Spirit for that to happen. Freedom will ban away the Darkseer. That's a bit of an interesting ban considering that Duop already have the Pit Ward. Maybe they had something in mind there. I'm not really too sure about that one. And we don't really see too many big combos with the Darkseer here. I guess maybe the Ember Spirit Sleight of Fist, but we don't really see them going for too many Battle Furies anymore, so not really sure where that ban comes in. Duop will ban away the Viper. Don't want to have to deal with that as an Ember Spirit. And that'll bring us to our last couple of picks. I'm very anxious to see how this works out. Team Freedom, with what they have, if Quinks can get a good start, they can definitely be hitting these towers down rather quickly. But Duop do have some nice wave clear. So we'll have to see how this goes for them. Just the way that Abaddon plays, that Axe Mike plays Abaddon, it's just been absolutely ridiculous at times. As Duop pick up a Timbersaw here, so I guess we're going to be seeing the support Pit Ward for them. I guess the Darkseer ban did make a lot of sense now with Timber being picked up. Be some very interesting lanes for Duop, for sure. And Team Freedom will have to find a way to get through this. I think the Timbersaw definitely could take a lot of damage, but they're starting to get to the point where they'll need to get a lot of these silences on the mark. And they'll get the Sandy Claws. Very interesting lineups here. It's almost difficult to tell exactly what's going on. Both teams going for a lot of offlaners. We'll just have to see what happens here, because this is something that we have not seen too much from either team. Certainly if we get into the late game situation, Duop are going to be outputting a huge amount of damage. But will Team Freedom even let them get to that point? That's really the question. They're picking really aggressive here. I mean, I don't think I've seen anything like this from either team. Like, going for that many tanky heroes for Duop and that much. I mean, both heroes are building really tanky right now. Maybe we're getting like a bit of a new meta being defined here. We'll have to see. Because I don't think too many people would predict that we'd be seeing these heroes coming out from the teams. So here we are into game number one between Duop and Team Freedom. This is the upper bracket final. Winner gets into the grand final. A free ticket there. And this is only game one of the best of three, so we've got some games coming after this, regardless of the result. But win here is definitely a big step towards making it even deeper into COD League. Not going through the lower bracket. So hopefully this is actually taking pretty, the game is paused right now. I don't know why. This is obviously one of the longer drafts that I've seen right now. Teams are just sitting here. I don't see anyone else chatting right now. No one's chatting. I guess we'll all just look at each other. Oh, there we go. The game is now paused. I see it in the middle of the screen. I'll just switch the overlay off for now because I think I was getting tired of looking at that. So, I guess we'll just settle in and wait for this to end. At least we have that music going on so that I'm not just sitting here talking to myself. At least listen to the music a little bit. and I'm very interested to see where this game ends up going. So here we are, we'll be getting into the game. Finally, we are ready, and we will get it unpaused. All right. So here we go. This is time for game number one. If they're ready. This is boring. Alright, so here we are into the match. Finally. This is a little bit boring. But whatever. We have some very early TPs out to the lane. Everyone's putting the ward in the high ground. We've got Biryu out with his own ward. And staking is just smoked for fun. Some people like to 420 blaze it. And Team Freedom, they're gonna 4-man smoke up the mid lane. Plus a little bit late, they're not getting their wards out so early. And we'll be taking a look at this lineup as BSJ has the Clinks, so got a mid SK. And they're gonna be running right up to the high ground here. They're gonna catch sight of Yuar. The smoke will break. Eagle doesn't even go for the charge. They're not gonna go for it right now. So Yuar was just going to keep himself safe for now. Freedom thinking about going for the high ground, but they just didn't really have the position to be able to do so. And now their wards are just not placed down at all. And they do put one right next to the Dire Observer, and if Duop really wants to, they would be able to deward that, but they don't have any sentries right now, so they'll just let Yuar know that there is a ward there, in case it mattered. Freedom will go with the defensive tri-lane, Abaddon, and eyeing Smike's usual position of trying to go man mode on the offlane. The nice thing about Sand King is he has that nice big butt in order to block the creep wave. Gotta love big butts. And Snake King is gonna be zoned down the lane pretty hard. He won't even get a chance to get any kind of XP. Twine wants to get back over to the mid lane, trying to harass out Yuar with the Caustic Finale, and he actually does a lot of work there. Abaddon possibly in some trouble at top, will get lifted up. 747. He's going to get the Searing Chains to keep Ice Mike there. He tried to TP away, and that will be the first blood. Fairy Fire popped. They need Clairvoyance to get some more damage, and actually Ice Mike will stay alive for now. Very surprising. He used a lot of resources trying to get away from there, the Fairy Fire and the TP, but he ends up managing to stay alive. And slowly but surely, Tomato will start to do a lot of damage to the Juggernaut in the mid lane. He won't be able to take down all these waves. Juby's taking the creep wave over towards the camps, trying to get it away from the Timbersaw. Ixmike trying to get into the lane a little bit more to get some levels, but it's not really working out too well for him. He'll go to the backside, trying to get the fire shield to pop a little bit onto the Rubick. But Ice Mike will not be doing too much damage with the Atrophy Aura still doing a lot of work. We got Freedom basically with a free lane at bottom, while Tomato tries to keep the Caustic Finale damage out onto Yuar. Abaddon's also going for a chase right now, so even though this lane hadn't really gone so well for him at the early part, Ice Mike is still managing to get a few levels here, and there will be a TP in from the Spirit Breaker. I think about going for one of these supports. Here he gets into the lane, and he gets some vision of Eagle, who's going to run over with the charge. He'll even get the second bash there, but Ike's mic wasn't close enough to help out. You are, Will. Oh, with the Burrow Strike being down, Tomato in a little bit of trouble. He used the Fairy Fire, tries to Manfoot against the Yawar Juggernaut, and he actually swags on him with the Burrow Strike. That is such a ridiculously low cooldown in the early game. Sand King just turns around and he does the thing where he kills the Juggernaut. A little bit too greedy with the spin there. Now 747 tries to get away from a few heroes. They need a little bit more of a bash from Eagle. They're not going to find it. Ice Mike throws out the Mistcoil. Now he gets very low again. There's another Aphotic Shield. 747 still staying alive and even getting blocked out a little bit by the creeps. Eagle might have needed to save Ice Mike there, but luckily for him, the Abaddon gets away. Meanwhile, Juby is still getting some farm right now on the dire side of the map. He's not had to do too much in this offlane. ESJ currently up to level 4 and the top of the last hits for now. You are taking so much ridiculous damage from the Caustic Finale. And Tomato knew that he wasn't going to be able to kill UR without his Burrow Strike being up, but this is actually just what a Sand King does against a Juggernaut solo. Like, he's gonna get a lot of Caustic Finale damage. The Glimpse goes back onto the Timber Saw. He tries to get the Timber Chain off, but Snake King is gonna be brought right back in the fight. BSJ looking for the vision that he needs. Snake King still with a lot of mana, and that will be the kill going to Juby. The Duop dropping a couple of kills here to Freedom, and that works right into Freedom's master plan. They absolutely have to be winning this game early. Nice little last hit from Ix Mike there with the Aphotic Shield popping. We're again going out for the spin, but that might be the call for Nora to get in there. Luckily for him, or perhaps unluckily, UR gets away from the Caustic Finale pops. Now the lift goes out on the Abaddon. The Pit of Malice will keep him there. He manages to get out before it procs again. That is only a level 1 Pit of Malice, so it's not going to be doing a whole lot here. And Ix Mike still stays alive at top. Is a magic stick available as well, so it's not like he's really gonna have to be in trouble from this. Tomato taking a little bit of damage from the spin on the mid lane, as the play right now for Yawar is just to keep that pushed out. And Juby looking for the glimpse, but Eagle would have had to go a little bit too far in for that one. And Juby, he sees the Rubick showing up, decides that he doesn't really want to take him away with the glimpse. He'd rather stay and play with a Rubick. Pop the shrine, giving him some much needed mana. He has to get in range of that shrine. BSJ stepping up against Snake King, and he has the Blight Stone already. Snake King will heal up a little bit, but the charge will come through. Eagle will be there. They have the glimpse back from Juby. They don't want to be underneath the tier 2 tower. BSJ is ready for some damage as well. He'll get the bash off as well. Snake King is so much damage. BSJ out of mana, but it doesn't matter at all. He's got more than enough to finish off the Timbersaw. And they might think about going on to Spearbreaker a little bit, but that could be just another charge going the way. Freedom, luckily for Duop there, the Pit of Malice was down, stopping any further progress on that kill, but that is something that they really do not want to be giving Freedom at this point. They've already given up 3 kills. The lanes are in absolute shambles. The support's having to rotate all over the map. This is not really the best or the most auspicious start for Duop. You got Beery sitting on some boots, but that's about all he's sitting on. Even with his big underwear butt, you can tell that I'm still a pretty big fan of big butts. I love him in a non-creepy way. You are still trying to farm, but look at this. We've got Sand King and BSJ up at the top of the last hits for now. Doing really well. Ix Mike puts out the Aphotic Shield, which 747 is perfectly okay with. He just wants to get through the magic damage a little bit. Ix Mike taking a lot of damage from this, and he does have the magic stick, but I don't know how much he's going to keep him alive. He actually denies himself instead of throwing out another Aphotic Shield. Probably smart against Eric Dong. So Ix Mike kills himself again. And he will very quickly get back over towards the top lane, TPing over to the shrine. That's actually a very smart move. It allows them, I guess, with some better access into the jungle. But I think one of the reasons why it's a smarter move is it makes it so that it won't be slower at TP's over to the tower. So if there were a kind of go from a duo up there, they'd be able to get a couple of TP rotations if they needed to. Underworld now sitting at bottom. BSJ thinking about moving up. We do have 747 getting a kill onto Eagle at top, so he wasn't actually able to charge away from that one. Now on the mid lane, you are possibly in some trouble. He's been these creeps down, but Disruptor won't be able to get in range for his glimpse. He was just trying to stay out of vision. A little bit too far away. In the mid lane, possibly you are trying to chase down the Tomato Sand King, but the Sand King has a double damage rune. He's also got a Disruptor here to help him out. The glimpse will be there. Tomato looking for the Burrow Strike. He'll find it on the Juggernaut, and that's some huge damage along with the double damage rune. That's not really something that UR wants to deal with so early, and that's the second death of the game already. And we have Freedom ready to push in this mid lane a little bit. Do you have BSJ going around to the side? Wants to get the wrap around. Him the reach around per se, and he'll go on to Biryu. It's not really going to be a kill, or will it? No. Really got enough damage at this point. But Freedom will back over to the mid lane, forcing out a couple of TP rotations again. He'll pop the Arcane Boots on Tomato, giving BSJ some amount of mana. And they'll play it safe around this tower. They don't really want to go on that tower too much right now. They still need to get a lot of farm on BSJ. We've got BSJ possibly taking some damage at bottom, but it's really not all that much. It's just a fade bolt, and he's got to be careful with his invis. Here comes a Chakram. Possibly a little bit early against him. They could have waited until the Underworld got into town, and he does arrive now, toting both of those, one of those blades. Doesn't have them in both hands. He's going to throw out the Pit of Malice, and well, BSJ gets caught in a few times, but there was not really too much going on from that. Gravepicker was charging down bottom, but still will get cancelled off as well. There's also some vision here for UR. So they'll have some pretty good vision of Jubi, or rather Eagle, rotating. IX Mike again trying to put out some damage at top. He's killing off the tower. Wants it to start attacking him as he did have the double aphotic shield. Tomato's ready with the Burrow Strike as well. He's trying to cut a few trees before the Spirit Breaker gets there. Now he is going to get scouted out with a very deep Dire Observer. And they are going to be a little bit late on this one because Tomato is not really going in. And now the Timber Chain is going to be down. Burrow Strike coming through. Epicenter there as well. There's his Spirit Breaker ultimate. And the Tomato has no chance of getting away from there. Meanwhile, at bottom, BSJ trying to get away from a big onslaught double remnant forward from 747. He needs to get those Searing Chains up, and they will be up now. Will they go into the tree? So you are looking for the damage that he needs as Clinks is not going to be seen anymore. Biryu, oh, what is... Well, luckily for him, Biryu does literally no damage, but he used to stick there right next to the pit where that was possibly really bad. Getting a little bit of lag here. Also, BSJ TP'd over to mid. So they could get some damage onto this tower if he really wants to. They see like so many heroes at bottom. This opens up the mid lane quite a bit for him, even though he is rather low on health. And, well, one of the things about Clinks is he's able to get some health back from eating the creeps next to him, and he's also got the healing sub as well, so he'll be back up to fighting shape pretty soon, and this might be two towers for Team Freedom. TP to the mid lane by Juggernaut. Yawar wants to get in here. He's got the Omni Slash, not too many members from his team, and Freedom could rotate onto him. BSJ stepping up, chasing UR away from the tower, and he can't get the deny. The charge will come through, but the rest of Duop are showing up. Rubik, he's got the lift. He'll use it out in the BSJ. Drop him a little bit far forward, and the Spirit Breaker is going to run around inside the Sagstorm. Doesn't really do all that much. UR will die. Glimpse back onto the Rubik. BSJ trying to move up here, but those Acolytes are going to be extremely scary. Here you putting down the mouse. I don't really see Duop wanting to go in here right now. So Freedom take another tower off the map. And Freedom are still going to be taking even more, honestly. Tomato up to his Aetherlands first. Like, he's gone. He went Arcane Boots into the Aetherlands. And he's nearly at his Blink Dagger as well. Yes, Jay. He may be. Yeah, he's nearly at his Desolator. In addition to the Blink Dagger nearly being picked up for the Sand King, so this bottom tower is not going to survive for too long against this Freedom push. And this is how they play most of their matches. And they only took a very small advantage out of the early game, but already they're trying to push in this tower, trying to take all the tier 1s off the map. It's 13 minutes in, and they could definitely go a little bit further with this one. They'll get another tower. Yeah, but Blink Dagger nearly is tanking. He's got level 10. Also has the epicenter available if they wanted to try to fight. Trying to make sure that Duop never gain their footing in this match. I guess the only one that's close is Eric Dong. He's currently on a Veil of Discord and level 11, so he's doing okay in farm for now, especially considering that he was in a tri lane for a while. Yes, Jay will find Snake King inside the jungle. This isn't really a Timbersaw that he's going to be able to kill. He needs at least a little bit more help, and Disruptor might be able to put down the Sagstorm. He'll drop it down! Now Timbersaw needs to be glimpsed back. He doesn't get away. The damage is there from BSJ, but they don't quite have the control that they need. Now BSJ might be in some trouble. Burrow Strike stolen by Rubick. They'll go in for the Trident to Timbersaw, but they initiate a little bit too quickly, and now Eagle will get burnt down by 747 and Yuwar as well. Omni Slash comes out. They'll secure two. That was a little bit too deep from Team Freedom, and not enough people showing up from their team either.
I'll take that as tribute.
All right, so we got Team Freedom still doing quite a bit, but they can't really give away more kills like that. Do have a Blink Dagger on Tomato, and he uses it to get into the lane right now. He's not even trying to hide it at all. He'll Burrow Strike away, but he could get caught out by a Juggernaut coming through. Juggernaut has a spin, and Tomato tries to TP away, and the Pit of Malice does not stop that at all. So, oh man, I guess this is going to be a pretty exciting game because Freedom, as we talked about, they are on a bit of a clock. 747 knows that Disruptor is hanging out near the mid lane, and he's also going to see the Spearbreaker coming in here right now. Charge does get canceled. Eventually, we'll see Freedom start to do a little bit more. Where is BSJ at? So, actually, when he gets into the Desolator, gonna be able to go for Roshan. So, Freedom very up on their timings right now. Here you will walk into the pit, but not sure how much he's going to be able to do. Freedom are getting a little bit low. BSJ slowed down inside the pit. That Pit of Malice is still doing a lot inside the Roshan pit. IX Mike wants to go forward. BSJ will get the Aegis popped on him. I'm not sure if that's going to be too far in for Duop. IX Mike has as good of another life as well, popping the bar of time, standing right next to 747. BSJ, he's in a bit of a bad place, and the blow up comes from the Renan. Three from 747. Epicenter is doing a lot, but GB has to get away. Tomato has to get out as well. The glimpse will go back on the 747. The shotgun comes through though. Juby, he will get the glimpse stone as well. And Team Freedom don't really do too well around the fight around the Roshan pit. Even though they get the Aegis, there was just too much control coming in from Duop, though. I mean, it's just a pit of malice, but they were sitting in a pit of malice for a while. Also, another pit of malice thrown out at mid, and they have to remember that there is always a glimpse from the Rubick. Maybe Duop are getting a bit far in here. Ice Mike is rushing forward. Can they kill him off before they leave? He'll actually go in and just feed as they all get out thanks to the Dark Rift. Unfortunately, a kitty cat was left behind, but there isn't too much you can do helping that. And Duop get a free kill around the tier 1. We'll get a pause, perhaps. Duop need to fix... Oh my god, would these casters just be quiet? I don't understand why they need to talk all the time in the lobby. Whatever. I'm not doing it. Well, in any case, BSJ will be working on his next item pretty soon. I would say that Team Freedom have a lot of time here because they did have a good early game, but the thing is, Duop are just coming back in fight after fight. And BSJ really cannot continue to stay in those kinds of fights for that long. He needs a lot of things right now. He needs a BKB, probably needs a Hurricane Pike. It's just not really working out for him right now. And the peel from his team isn't gonna be too much right now. So we'll get back into the game right now. You are, after that terrible start, is starting to get a little bit more form. He is getting closer to his Yasha and then his Manta style. We've got Boots to Travel on Eric Dong, and he's also got a Radiance coming in as well. Things don't really looking... I mean... Oh, Juby. He's gonna glimpse back the Timbersaw. He'll get off the Whirling Death, but that doesn't do as much to a Disruptor as it does to other heroes. I guess he was also touched by just the tip of it, BSJ. He needs so much to deal with an Ember Spirit at this point. Can put out some huge damage, but the thing is, he needs some control from his team, and I wouldn't really say that do Team Freedom have the vision that they need to do that right now. So Team Freedom is still trying to push in some towers. They're getting the mid lane pushed out, thinking like they should try to do something right now. You see a 4-staff being built up for Tomato. Smoke comes in from Freedom. Might get caught off by the shrine, but that might be perfectly what he wants. Here's the stun from the Tomato. He's right next to it, but he'll try to run away from the shrine instead of activating it and trying to stay alive. It was definitely a lot of damage from Team Freedom. SGB looking for the vision that he needs to get the glimpse off, and Eric Dong tries to run it away, but that wasn't going to get him out. That is a lot of damage on the Disruptor. He's not got a lot of utility right now. He tries to get away. Rubick's nearly killing him off, and Rubick will end up dying. BSJ now, he's going for the Ember Spirit. That's a lot of damage that they'd be taking down, but BSJ can't find the range that he needs. No Dragon Lens for him, and it might be a little bit too much. Mechanism will keep him alive for now. They've killed off the Timbersaw, and they're looking for the damage with the Epicenter. He burrow strikes over the trees, and they'll be able to get off four inside the jungle, starting with Yuar and then moving on to everybody else. Freedom do manage to get a really nice fight here, bringing them a little bit back into this game. Ember Spirit will try his best to try to defend this one. But BSJ, he's gonna walk right up. He's actually going for a Diffusal Blade. He pops a Strafe and has to do a huge amount of damage. Yuar will spin away from Tomato, who manages to pop the Aestrion there. Glimpse back on the Yuar. He's not going to get caught in the middle of the kinetic field, but the charge will come through from Eagle. Duop in trouble. We've got Eagle finding another kill. Meanwhile, BSJ was just taking a mid tower free of charge. Not gonna get hit it all there. 747 moving up here. Dark Rift will get them away. They'll drop down a lot of damage, but BSJ is not even close to going down right now. They'll actually cancel the Dark Rift. They're going to be kept here. BSJ still in the middle of the... in the middle of the Pit of Malice. And they'll find a kill onto Eric Dung. Snake King tries to go through, but he's going to miss the Timber Chain. Snake King nearly dying, popping the Hood of Defiance on himself. The Burrow Strike comes through. No Timber Chain for you. Throwing out another Shocker, but that's just going to expire. As all of Doo-Up are now dead, it seems mightily quiet on the map for them as Freedom keep pushing in these lanes. Oh my lord. There is just nothing that Doo-Up can do right now. BSJ with the rest of Team Freedom to the high ground, having no mercy on that lone catapult. They'll go for the high ground. They'll take down a tier 3. It's 21 and a half minutes. There was a time when you thought Doo-Up were getting into this one. Maybe they could be right now. Eagle getting caught out underneath the firestorm. But through all of that, BSJ still took the racks. He just does way too much damage with the Desolator. And there was no stopping him there. And Doo-Up were doing okay for a while, but then Yawar gets caught out, 747 gets caught out, and BSJ just does a ridiculous amount of damage. It just has not been Doo-Up's game for the past 2 minutes, and that's just how quick it's been. We had about 3 minutes of wins for Team Freedom. They've kept their heads behind them. They didn't really worry about the Ember Spirit damage, because the thing about Ember Spirit is, although he can put out a huge amount of damage, if he can't get away, he's going to probably die very quickly, especially with BSJ throwing out a lot of damage. So Freedom will start to work back down the mid lane. Perhaps they just want to end this game right here. Doesn't really seem like the best idea. They still have a couple of tier 2s to go for. GB taking some control. Alright, they're setting up the wards in the bottom lane, trying to make sure that one is going to be their next go. But Freedom, they are ready inside the jungle. Look at all this warding around the bottom lane. Like, they have so much here. They could see literally anything on the Doo-Up side that they wanted. And look how fast these towers just melt to BSJ. He goes right to the defusal level 2. And these towers just stand no chance. They have the Curse of Avernus on them. They have the Clinks damage as well. I mean, you thought that this game was supposed to end very early if Team Freedom were supposed to win. And indeed, they are pushing super hard here. It is now being dropped down. But BSJ now has the range to be able to kill off this tier 3 tower. They should be able to get another one. Firestorm being dropped. BSJ running right through it as if it were just butter. BSJ taking a little bit of damage, but it looks like he doesn't even care about Snake King hitting him in the face. And the Burrow Strike comes through. There's a Stag Storm on the 3. Freedom have them all caught out except the Clairvoyance Rubik, though. And Epicenter will come through as well. Buyback by UR. Can't even do anything right now. 747 back. Freedom, they need to just have their things together here. BSJ looking for a little bit more damage. Kinetic Field will be knocking things out. Eagle looking for the charge across. He's not actually going to get hit by the Syrian Chains triple run at 4. Popping the 8-5 kill on the Eagle. Can he even get away? He's going to be saved again by the Mist Coil. And BSJ, he's nearly dead, will actually die. Omni Slash coming through. Can UR actually get killed off here? Timber Chain again going to be off the mark. Eagle just wants to force this out and create some space for his team. He's going to walk right into the Den of Lions called the Dire Base. Will end up dying, but I think he's gotten Tomato away. Very close fight. Couple of buybacks needed. Next time, Doo-Up won't have those. And even when they had the buybacks, they still lost the melee racks and all that chaos. It's not really been the best game for them at all. Even though 747 has gotten to Irradiance, it's just not really making too much of a difference for him. Doo-Up will go in on a tier 1 tower, and they will be able to take it this time. But Tomato is still keeping bottom pushed out. Doo-Up have only taken care of one lane. That is it. With IX Mike sitting on the mid lane, just getting as tanky as possible. This is really all he does on most of his heroes. He goes Arcane Boost, picks up a Mechanism, and then tries to win from there. And you could kind of tell as soon as Team Freedom got their Mechanism up, And things started to change in their favor. Freedom smoked up, looking for that killing blow. Over to Duop. Oh, but they might have just found Eric Dong. I think he might have actually broke a couple of smokes with the remnant through. Ice Mike stepping up a little bit too far. Duop trying to play a little bit as a unit here. They do have a lot of farm on 747. He's going to get a blink dagger right now. So perhaps Duop can try to turn it around here, but they've just lost so much so early. 26 and a half minutes in, we're already down two melee racks. It's a lot of pressure that Duop are going to be under. Maybe JB will get caught up here. He's going to get caught inside of the pit of mouse. Tries to get away, but he will be lifted, thrown back in. I don't really think the Disruptor can get away here. Meanwhile, Juggernaut will put the Omni Slash out on the Eagle. They'll find two supports and look for Roshan, but this is a very long respawn. And Tomato's still pushing in bottom. I'm gonna have to respond to this pretty soon. I'm sure it's only a Sand King, but you don't really want to lose another ranged racks right now. Or lose any more of your racks. Duop into the Roshan pit. I think any kind of thing they can, but Quink Solution is gonna go in, and it might be there fast enough. Roshan is taking a lot of damage. The illusion will just wander in. Be quickly farmed. Ice Mike runs in the pit. He knows what's needed. He's got his fire time as well. He's gonna start to try to take it down. Dark Rift will take Duop away. The Dire will kill off Roshan, but the Aegis is still on the ground. Yuar is gonna take it. They go into the pit, and they actually get away, but without Yuar because that Aegis has been popped. So they're gonna leave the Juggernaut there. And Rubik's gonna get picked off. Duar inside the pit. They couldn't save him with the Dark Rift. They couldn't keep him up in time. And they're gonna throw BSJ with some damage to the high ground, putting the sentry right next to the Rubik and get another kill there. Some people just can't be saved by Dark Rift. And the last tier 2 could very quickly belong to Team Freedom pretty soon. Are you stepping up at top? He's got a gem. Luckily for him, he hasn't died with it. 747 over to the side, but there's no vision right now for Team Freedom, and there isn't likely to be anytime soon. 747 will go for this creep wave, trying to keep it pushed out, so it's a lot more difficult for Freedom to push this in. Do have a couple of creeps here, and as soon as they get over to the tower, BSJ in with the huge damage that he's been dealing out this entire match. Dragonlance also available for him. Look at Ike's Mike keeping that catapult up. They'll stun out the Underlord. Pitward trying to get away, dropping down the pit of mouse, or he tries to, has absolutely no time to do anything, got caught dewarding. And the last tier 2 tower belongs to Team Freedom, with the Abyssal Underlord being down. They may even decide to go for the high ground. BFJ actually pretty tanky right now. He's at 2500 health. He doesn't have the Aegis, and he's going to get a lot of damage. Triple Remnant in, but it only hits on the Disruptor. He'll drop on the Stags as he tries to get away from here. He hasn't died just yet, though. He's still being healed. Snake King trying to do some damage on the backside, but again, he's just going to fall right away. 747 into the fight. Can he get taken down here? He does. Oh, does he have a Remnant? He used a lot of those in his initiation to the fight. Freedom might have just been forced back for now, but they might try to go in. BSJ's on rather full health. He's gonna get hit with the Scary Chains. Pit of Mouse is there as well. Ike Mike needs to get away from that Pit of Mouse because BSJ, he's just standing and doing the damage you are. He's not gonna be able to stay alive. BSJ gets up, but he's got the Aphotic Shield on him. 747 looking for the damage to win this one. Couple of heroes right next to the tower. Tomato will end up dying. Ike Mike also in some trouble as well. Doesn't have another Borrowed Chains for another, or Borrowed Time for another 18 seconds. So we'll see if he can get the this coil off. He gets the Aphotic Shield to give himself some more time, but it's gonna be a triple kill for 747. Meanwhile, creeps are wreaking havoc inside the base. They'll take down both of the range tracks and start to work on those shrines. Tier 3 tower standing strong on the top for Duop, but that seems to be about the only thing that is standing strong for them right now. Just checking to see if I have any drop frames. I can see hitbox lag for a second there. But we'll get back into the base. Spirit needs to get some of that mana back up. Team Freedom, they are still so very far ahead right now, and they have both. They have two sets of racks. And what BSJ has is going to be the finishing of the Hurricane Pike for him. Yuar's just been so far behind this entire game. Just now getting the Maelstrom and looking for a Manta style, but this is bargain bin Juggernaut. It's just not really been the best game for him here. 747 certainly has a lot of gold to speak of. He's actually still just behind Clinks on the net worth. But I don't think he's going to be getting too many victories from that, as Freedom are still creating pressure on the top lane. They don't have an Aegis for this push again. ESG might just think about going for the tower. Freedom start to get that push off from the top lane, as the Dark Rift is used by Biryu to get quickly over to the top lane. BSJ ready with some damage. Drums get popped. Look at the BKB of the high ground. BSJ just starts to go to work. He will get hit by the net. Troll doing a little bit of work there. Omnisash going around. BSJ, he'll take the tier 3 tower and he'll get out of the base. Now the rest of Duop are getting a little bit far ahead of themselves. Ghostcepter gets used onto the Tumor Cells. He still takes no damage inside of that Sack Storm. Beastal Underworld will die. You are in a little bit of trouble. They need to get more of that BSJ, that sexy BSJ damage onto him. We'll get hit by the Syrian Chains again. 747 still doing a lot of magic damage. A couple of remnants forward, but they're moving so slow that BSJ is able to avoid them. Eagle still managing to die there. And the Epicenter charged up. Snake King will be able to get the double. And the Ghost Scepter will keep him alive for now. Axe making a little bit of damage. BSJ in some trouble as well. Wants to go for the Rubick, but he's just not going to have the survivability he needs, as Axe Mike will go down as well. Griefs are still doing damage inside the base, killing off one of the shrines there. Tier 4 towers are going to manage to stand against this. So every single time the Team Freedom go for a fight, they are losing something. Losing a lot. But did manage to take a tier 3 tower with that one. Do have a lot of items onto 747 though. Really a lot. And it'll be the Bloodstone for Snake King as well. Tomorrow starts to go to work on the shrines. He sees the Ember Spirit coming in. He will get charged. 747 goes and takes care of the illusions near the shrine. The charge gets cancelled by Spirit Breaker. Not really too much of a point in going there at all. So right now, Duop is trying to hold on to anything they can against this. There is a ward on the high ground from Freedom. They might just push out the top lane again and try to go for the win. It's what they've been doing for the past 6 minutes, really. Is Coil currently in the possession of Rubick. Ice Mike pushing bottom by himself, and he's gonna possibly run into a lot of trouble. 747 actually going for a blink, and he misses it on the Ice Mike. Ice Mike very narrowly dodging the bullet there. I don't know how he managed to avoid that one, but even so, he does. Now Quink's possibly the new Weaver. He has the possibility of getting a lot more tanky, and honestly, can put out a huge amount of damage early as well. Shrine nearly as good as Geminate's attack. I don't know. I honestly would like to see teams pick Clinks a little bit more than the Weaver. Like, sure, Weaver has that inherent Iron's armor with the Swarm, but Quinks does very similar things as well. And he can take these towers down extremely fast. 747 moving forward, actually blinking into this one. He still has that remnant away, which he does manage to get. It would be interesting if the Disruptor was able to put a Sack Storm and try to get the silence onto Ember Spirit there. Looking at our buybacks. The only Dire here, we have buybacks on both Snaking and Clairvoyance, so they'll be able to get that. They will not hit the Kinetic Field, but they'll manage to find the Yule Scepter out onto Snaking. He will Timber Chain away. Tamano looking for the Burrow Strike. BSJ in with a lot of damage. 747 will get into the fight. BSJ possibly a little bit far up here. Snaking manages to find the kill, but 747 will be glimpsed away. Eduard is into this one. BSJ possibly getting a lot of damage on. Amistad doing a lot of work on him. It looks like that Amistad never ends. BSA trying to turn around, looking for some damage on Yuar. It's going to be a man fight, one that Yuar will very easily win, but eventually he will get chased down by the rest of Team Freedom. It's a 3-for-3. Florence will get out. Oh, here comes the Ember Spirit in the middle of that one. He finds Abaddon, who still has the Bar of Time, as well as the Guardian Greaves and Pipe of Insight. Blink forward, we've got Spiritbreaker charging away. He's gonna stay there for now. Ix Mike still taking a lot of damage, has a bar time available. Rubick possibly in some trouble. He's gonna keep Eagle there for just a little bit longer. As Team Freedom, they can't really find anything more there. Charge out by Rubick, one of the interesting things that he does, wants to make sure that the mid lane doesn't keep being pushed out. I think I just threw up a little bit inside my mouth. This game is getting pretty interesting, I'd say. Because it's like a big balance between what Duop can do with their Ember Spirit and then what Team Freedom can push. It's just a very tight line that both teams are walking. They have pretty specific things that they have to do in order to win fights. Ix Mike wanting to push in the mid lane. Other lanes are getting pushed out as well. Ix Mike really needs BSA for this one, but he's going to be rushing through his own jungle, looking for any hero that's hanging out here. 2400 gold for Quinks. And he'll walk right in onto the mid lane. 747 does have his flame guard. He throws out the Searing Chains on the BSA, who will force staff out. Sheikah's guard gets used. BSA trying to turn it around. They get the Spirit Breaker ultimate. BSA! No. It's just not enough damage. Ix Mike still having the Bar of Time at top. He'll use the Guardian Greaves, get right back up there. But Duop can't go too much further onto this one. Roshan will respond in a couple of seconds. Ix Mike taking a lot of damage from these bits of Duop aggression. Ix Mike will TP away. As we have Duop looking for a smoke, he might go into the Roshan pit. And Tamano could scout them out. He's going to break the smoke on Biryu. And might see what's going on there. He will get charged by the Spirit Breaker. He really doesn't want to go in there, though. Neither team can really go too hard into Roshan right now. 747 checking for a couple of heroes. BSJ is starting to move in. And to throw out one to attack, he's pretty far in here. He can't get cut off by Yuar. And he's going to turn around. There's the BKB. And Yuar and 747 in the middle of that kinetic field. Nice Summer Cape keeping 747 alive. But Yuar will end up dying. And BSJ is still doing a ton of damage. He'll use the Dark Rift to try to get away. They need to kill off the Abyssal Underworld. They're trying to get onto him. But the Abyssal Lord manages to save all of them. As Juggernaut also buys back. This is also going to be a cheese Roshan for Freedom. Top lane's been pushed out quite a bit. They know that there is not a buyback anymore on the Juggernaut. There is one on both the Snake King and Eric Dong, Ember Spirit, as well as Clairvoyance. So, Duop are still possibly okay, even if they lose a couple of heroes, but when you start getting to all those buybacks up, it's really not a good thing. As BSJ tries to walk right into the Dire base, the gem is on Rubick right now. He has to be careful not to get caught out, as Rubick is going to steal the skeleton walk. Managed to take this creep wave out. 747 going in with the Sheba's guard. Initiation in from Duop. Eagle in a little bit of trouble. Needs to stay alive. But we've got a hex out onto the Ember Spirit. He's not getting away right now. They'll go right for him and they'll manage to kill him off. Now we've got a buyback by the Ember Spirit. Tip of Mouth also being thrown out, keeping Ix Mike in place there. Clairvoyance trying to back away from him. And here comes the Epicenter and the Frozen Strike in from the backside. Triple Remnant out, but he's got the Sag Storm as well on the three. Where is this damage coming from? From Freedom. Ix Mike in the middle of everything. That's just a Borrow time. The Clairvoyant is getting right back into it, but Yuar, his buyback's down, and he's going to be dead right now. Dragonborn is also trying to go away. They'll get the smoke out. They need to make sure that the Ember Spirit dies. They'll stun him up. They'll get the charge through. Nicely dodged by the Slight Fist. Can they actually turn this around? Lots of damage from the Whirling Death. They've got a couple of targets that they need to go on right now. As Ixmite continues to go forward here, he'll eat the cheese. Stay Cake trying to just tank up as much damage as possible. He will end up dying. Rubick with the Yule Scepter up. Tomato. Oh, we've got the buyback by the Timbersaw as well. Suck will lie dead as they just want the Megas. The Fortification gets used. BSJ, he's not even worried about it right though. He just wants to hit all those arrows and they will not be able to get him. Now 747 also taking a lot of damage. BSJ just hitting away, and he actually manages to kill the Rubick. Looking for another one. Hit of Mouse will keep him there. Will probably die to the Timbersaw. Chakram comes through. Eventually he dies in Ix Mike. He had another bar of time that entire thing, and BSJ, he still had the Aegis, so he'll be right back up. Taking a lot of damage from Timbersaw. Really needs to get another death pack, but now the Ember Spirit, he'll stand right there and he won't even be able to get those remnants off. That's a GG. Duop can't stand at all. What a game from both of them, really, but Team Freedom with the absolutely fantastic push. That was really incredible to watch. And PSJ working with that Aegis as best